purpose to lock us in this shelter.
We're back. Here we go.
Do you?
Hold on, I forgot to hit the record button.
It's pointless. I checked it already.
Damn. We've retracted. It's been a year. 22 years since Maria was born. Never thought there'd be a time when I could wish a happy new year. This is the worst year ever.
Is she your girlfriend?
No. She's my little sister. She, fell ill 10 years ago and was admitted to the hospital. Figured she'd be lonely.
Uh-oh, it's sad backstory time.
That's... Every good morning, good night was so important to us. And now...
And then you can't say it because you're trapped with the likes of me.
That's right. Happy New Year, Junpei.
What's with you all of a sudden?
All of a sudden?
I wanted to say that to you for 10 years, but I couldn't.
You say it now.
I'm not sure what I'm supposed to say.
At least give her a proper response. You're her boyfriend, right?
No, I am not.
Yes, you are.
She's just a childhood friend.
Really? And here I thought you were dating. I'm sorry if I made things awkward. I just wanted to learn how you guys were connected. The best way to build teamwork is to know who your partners are.
How like a firefighter.
Well, leave it at that for now. Okay, we can't hang around here like this forever.
Puzzle time. What is this white stuff against the walls? Are we not going to... Door cannot be opened due to insufficient power. So the door won't open. Thank you. power switch for the locker. Let's see what happens when we turn it. Follow the light chain. If the power is going where the switch pointed, now we can open this. It's puzzle time. What the fuckery duckery is this? It's got to be like that, right? There we go! Sink plug. Two sink plugs. Okay, now if we redirect power this way, that should allow us to open this locker. Yeah, how do I close it? We should check the water valve. Can we change the thermometer? Okay. I am at a loss now. Oh wait, there's something here. Okay, there should be matches somewhere on the ground here. I don't see them. Okay, apparently they are right here. Don't know how I was supposed to see that. a key. That goes in the keyhole, I'm guessing. Now we can pull this lever. So what did that do? Oh, this unfroze. Do we sell those matches? Can we melt the ice with fire? It doesn't look frozen solid to me. It doesn't look frozen to me. It's literally not frozen solid, though! It's literally not frozen solid! What the fuck? Does this look frozen solid to you? Oh. Oh boy! This is a puzzle that I'll be looking up the answer to. Oh, what the fuck is this? This is also a puzzle I'll be looking up an answer to. Uh-oh. Can we freeze the water?
She's okay. She's just unconscious. Her breathing and pulse are normal.
Akane, you idiot!
Now announcing the current casualties. QT, Q, Mira, M. These three are now deceased. As a result, three exorcists will be revealed. I, Q, that is all.
QT.
Been revoked.
No, we can't be sure all of QT was really killed.
Yeah. You're right.
We need to focus on getting out of here somehow.
You seem to be forgetting that the exit's still locked.
Well then, all we can do is go into that room. What the hell is this thing? Akane?
She's laying down outside.
Yeah. Okay.
What the hell is this?
No clue. Something's up on the monitor, though.
Rules of the AB game. Players, Carlos and Junpei. Stand before the monitor and choose to ally or betray. You must vote at the same time. If the timing is off, everyone within the shelter. You start with 3 BP. Okay. So it's an AB game. When either player's BP reaches 9, when your BP drop... You just need to pick ally twice.
Ally or betray.
Well, what will it be, Carlos?
What are you saying? Isn't it obvious? We choose ally twice. We'll add 6 additional points to our initial 3. And we'll both end up with 9 BP. Zero's...
Hey.
No!
She's always been really smart. If she thinks that.
Not morphogenetic sorrow.
She'll start to believe.
Buts and ifs. Like someone at least twice her age.
But to all of us, back in grade school,
she was pretty strange. Well, I guess she came across as scary.
Did she get bullied a lot?
No. It was just. Well, not many people wanted to be friends. I always saw her sitting in a corner, curled up, hugging her knees, all alone.
Aww.
I decided to stay by her side, to watch over her and protect her, if I could. Then one day, my beloved rabbits were killed by some stupid middle schoolers having fun. She didn't take it well. So, without telling me or the teachers, she went to their hutch, crying and
apologizing over and over to them.
Oh.
That was over 10 years ago. A memory that's been tucked away in my brain, covered in dust. When I saw her again last year, I was reminded of that time. I just can't not keep an eye on her. I know. She always goes and just quietly shoulders everything herself. That's why I want to protect her. I wanted to help her bear whatever weight she's taken up. I truly felt that. But, well, I don't know. It was like I didn't know her as well as I thought I did. Hell, I couldn't understand why I even cared. I wanted to find out more about who she really was.
Fucking marry her already!
And see her. Come on, you have someone you really care about, don't you?
You mean my sister?
Yeah.
My parents died in a fire. And then Maria fell ill to an incurable disease. Above anything else, I want to save her. I see her smiling before. That's what I decided. That's why.
Ah, now I get it. That's why you need the $500,000.
It's clear we both have someone we want to protect, and neither of us can afford to die now.
Right.
So let's get out of this room.
Yeah.
Don't get the timing. We have to.
I know.
All right.
What the fuck, Junpei?
What the? Why?
Sorry. There's nothing gained by choosing betrayal, right? You said that. You forgot, Carlos. There actually was something.
What is gained?
3 and Q team, currently dead. The X door will be able to be opened.
Oh.
The same fate.
Because Diana and...
You died.
And then you... And then you and Akane can escape.
No.
I got it.
So then, you...
We'll take it the wrong way.
Well played.
Choose betray so I can escape. I know you'd do anything for the little sister you love. So that's why I figured you'd choose to push betray yourself. So, essentially, there's a Japanese saying, assume everyone you meet is a thief.
Well played.
It means you should never trust.
Well played, Junpei.
Don't we hide?
Once.
Hey, are you okay? Why is it so? Why do I think there was enough?
Mm-hmm.
There's a Japanese saying, assume everyone you meet is a thief. It means you should never trust strangers so easily. This is like, I'm on fire. Maybe I.
Oh! Oh. Okay, Akane. Understandable.
Junpei.
Oh, you're done too, because...
Did she... No. Where? You okay? Is this before the AB game? What? Okay... should I keep going? Yeah. Okay, I saw her sitting in the corner, curled up, heavy knees, and all alone. I decided I'd stay by her side to watch over and protect her if I could. Huh? Then one day, her beloved rabbits were killed by some stupid middle schoolers having fun. She went to their hutch, crying and apologizing over and over to them.
How do you know that?
Did Akane tell you? No. Then why?
So, gonna stay silent, huh? Fine. Guess there's no point talking about this. Let's just get these votes.
No, wait! Something's weird.
Hello, pot calling kettle.
Whatever I chose in the AB game, it was always the worst outcome.
What are you talking about?
Junpei? Carlos? Understand. I believe that what you just did was shift, Carlos.
Shift?
Space-time human internal fluctuating transfer.
Okay.
A phenomenon where one's mind crosses space and time.
Akane, what's that?
The power we used a year ago? The ability to send and receive information through the morphogenetic field. It's a simpler version of this.
You're saying me here right now came from a different history?
Well, your consciousness at least. Say you go back in time to when your parents met, using a car as a time machine. Know what movie I'm talking about?
Back to the Future.
Yeah, of course I do. The high school protagonist almost gets it on with his own mother and tries to get his awkward dad to marry her. That's the basic plot, right?
Yes, the story revolves around a boy. We'll call him M. Now, according to the plot, he's successful at getting his parents to marry.
What is his name again? Marty?
Ends up changing slightly. Upon returning to his own time, his father's a famous science fiction writer, pretend he's rich.
Huh. I guess the hierarchy was switched when his dad punched the neighborhood bully.
But did you notice something odd about the movie? Just what happened to the M who lived in that fancy house?
Huh. Now that you mention it.
I don't think the M from that history appears in the movie at all.
There are two overarching types of stories about time travel. The first type states that there is always only one history. Meaning, if someone changes the past, that previous past is subsequently erased.
Mm-hmm.
The other type is where multiple histories exist. This is the many worlds interpretation, one of the more widely believed hypotheses on multiverse theory. The world and universe split into branches as a result of one's decisions. It's a setup where each branch is able to exist in some form. Okay, so back to the movie. First, let's consider what happens with a single path history. In this case, do you know what M is doing back in his own time?
What he's doing?
Committing a form of murder.
Murder?
Well, think about it. The M who grew up in that fancy house, let's call him M2. M2 should have had a variety of amazing memories from his life.
True.
Maybe he met a really cute girl he liked, or was a winner of a contest. The possibilities are endless. All of those memories, every single one was overwritten when M came from another history.
Huh. But the history that disappeared was poor M's.
You're right, that's true. What was erased from existing in time was M's history. But the only memories that M retained
are those of when he was poor.
So, in effect, the life that M2 lived through was overwritten, all because of the actions that the protagonist M took to save his own. I'd say that's the same as killing someone, don't you think? Next is the multiverse hypothesis. In this situation, M2's life is never erased. Instead, a mystery remains. So, where did M2, the version who remembers being well off, up and disappear to?
Where he went.
This is what I think. On the same day that protagonist M used the time machine, M2, for some reason, did the same as M and went back to the past. But then, he did the exact opposite of M.
The opposite?
Mm-hmm. He stopped his dad from punching the bully.
So, when he returned to his own time, it was the world poor M had lived in.
Are you saying that they pretty much switched places?
It would keep everything consistent.
That's depressing.
What is?
M2's situation. Well, he ends up getting the bum end of the deal, regardless of which scenario happens.
Damn, that's pretty unfair.
Yes, that's true. But this is rather difficult to say, Carlos. Your case may be exactly the same.
What?
So did we just kill Carlos too?
Consciousness could have come from another history and taken over this body. In exchange, the Carlos who was here originally...
No.
He's now in one of the places where we died.
Other history?
There's no use in getting upset. You simply need to accept that that's what shifting is.
So he essentially doomed another one of us to death.
But wait, Akane, how did you know that Carlos is able to shift?
He mentioned before that he knows which path has death at the end and which is safe. I just sort of knew, too.
An arsonist set fire to our house when I was 18. My parents didn't make it, though I was able to get my sister Maria out. But we didn't make a clean escape. Maria fell into some sort of coma. They first thought that she had carbon monoxide poisoning, but that wasn't what it was.
Reverend Sithra, a variety of moments flicker in and out of the mind, as if one was constantly dreaming. We believe this is what your sister has.
Maria is either receiving large amounts of information from the morphogenetic field, or her consciousness cannot stop its jumping between multiple histories.
Huh?
Then she's like us.
Yes. Though it's slightly different. In Maria's case, that power is running rampant within her. That is what the reverie syndrome really is.
What?
If a way can be found to control the ability, then she could recover from it.
Is that true?
I see. That's good. So there's some hope for her.
Hey, Carlos. When you dove into the fire to save your sister, you were able to hear her voice, right?
Yeah, I was.
Carlos, I'm here! I'm over here!
Maria! Maria, is that you? Just stay there! I'm coming to get you!
No matter how you look at it, there was no way her voice could reach me. But
yet it did.
I realized exactly where she was, and I found her quickly. That was the first time. After that, I could hear victims crying out in the fires, and which way would lead to my death.
This ability we have is triggered by intense danger.
When we're threatened by a crisis, it's easier for us to access the field.
I get it. So that's what it was.
So, Carlos, Junpei, shall we shift?
Huh? What?
There's really no reason to play the AB game. Well, as it stands right now, it's incredibly likely the both of you will decide to pick Ally. But instead of going through that, it'd be better to shift to another history. It'll work! The three of us will definitely be able to do it! But only...
Why are they re-
if we find our lives in danger.
What do you mean by danger?
Why are you rewriting what the fucking... us from the other history, as well as the entire D team.
History we switch with will end up.
Do you plan on dying here then?
Oh. So, where do we need to jump to?
If we knew in advance, the effect of the threat would be lessened.
You're not affected by any of this at all, are you?
That's not true. Here, look. My heart's pounding so fast. Wanna check it?
Hey, it's kinda getting down to the wire here.
So why are they suddenly, like, rewriting how the morphogenetic field work.
We're just gonna have to go for it. Jump to the same history I am.
The same history?
Which one?
Think. There's a history when we didn't get all ones on the dice rolls. The moment right after that.
When we're about to be shot?
Are you insane? We're just gonna get ourselves killed. It's okay.
And how do we know that? Weren't our memories erased? Live 54, 23. Okay, we've been streaming for nearly an hour. Well, it's obvious where we go now.
Did it work?
But this is...
Hurry, Junpei! What was your idea? Right. First. What the hell? Carlos, put Akane in the fireplace.
Huh?
Just do it!
Through another history.
Listen, Carlos and I will protect you and die.
The fuck? Don't worry, it'll be fine. Before we die, we just need to shift to another history. Once you hear all of the X-passes, Akane, you should follow right away.
The X-passes?
In this history, 5 are already dead. 5's the only other one alive. That means 5 X-passes will be revealed. If Carlos's and mine are added to that, then there'll be 7.
No!
Damn it, Junpei! What the hell is this plan?
You're going to help, right?
God damn it!
Please! Don't do this!
We can't go back now. This is the only way.
Where are we jumping?
To the history when we rolled the dice and they were all ones.
Okay. Let's do this then. Let's protect Akane. No matter what.
Count on you, Carlos.
No! No, 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 no!
So you have to see your friends die right in front of you, your boyfriend die right in front of you? That fucking sucks, bro. How did Diana and Sigma die?
CT, Carlos, Junpei. The 7.
Wait, is this the timeline where they shot the bullet and it had a live round?
X-passes will be revealed. I kill 4. Fate. Save. Doll. That is all.
Ha ha ha! I should go now.
How are you shifting right there? Your life needs to be in danger. Right? Geronimo.
What in the world were you thinking?
What is your problem? Look, the three of us shifted just fine, so what's the big deal?
It's not okay.
We did get 7X passes at least.
Not you too, Carlos. I can't believe you! You always were like that, weren't you, Junpei? When we were in sixth grade, you faced those rabbit-killing middle school kids alone. There were probably other ways of handling it, but you rushed right in. Even the shifting. It's okay because it worked, but what if I was left behind there?
Well, I figured you could escape alone then, or something.
But that way of thinking is completely wrong. Being the sole survivor does not make me happy. There's no point in living once you lose the one you care about the most.
Akane. Sorry. I never meant to ever cause you pain like that.
What's that?
Well,
finally!
Back in elementary school.
Fucking finally you're proposing to her.
On your left hand. So, what's the matter?
Junpei.
Finally, they get to fucking be happy for once. They get to fucking be happy for once. Yes! This is what I wanted. This is the ending I wanted.
Thank you so much. But you know this is my right hand, don't you?
Wait. What?
Loser. Failed.
You're right. It looked like the left from my side, so.
That's just like you, Junpei.
Well, we'll move it to the correct finger later. I'll do it officially after we escape from here.
I understand. So, until then, I'll leave an empty spot open. It's been put on reserve.
Just Carlos sitting in the back.
Akane, do you remember the X-passes for Junpei and me?
Yes. Normally, when someone shifts, they forget the memories from the last time. But I'm used to it. It's all there.
Wait, hold on. Carlos and I remember what happened before, too.
Huh. I think those with the ability to shift...
But why have three shifters gathered in a place like this?
Doesn't really seem like a coincidence.
True. Even if we really are seeing more shifters in the world, the probability...
Wait. The numbers are increasing?
Mankind is about to face an unprecedented crisis. As it stands now, we lose 6 billion lives. I assume mankind has sensed that and is adapting. Even though it's, in reality, only a small portion. There's no way there are tens of thousands of shifters.
Then it's definitely on purpose. But we signed up for DCOM of our own free will. Maybe we just think that. And in actuality,
we did exactly what Zero wanted?
It's highly possible.
Ah, damn! What is that bastard thinking?
Wasn't it because he needed us to shift?
Why would that be important?
It'll all be over once we get out of here, anyway.
You're right.
We couldn't care less what Zero has planned at this point.
We need 6 X-Passes. We know 5 of them already, so one more. Akane, tell us one of the other X-Passes.
It's Save.
Error!
Hey, what the hell?
Wait. Is the X-Pass wrong somehow?
That can't be!
Let's try the other one too!
Akane!
It's Doll.
What the?
No way.
But why?
Now this is hilarious! How perfect! Why did we even struggle through all of that just now? Those guns turned my body into Swiss cheese. And you're telling me that it was all for nothing? All we did was die in vain?
Well, you finally got the fucking courage to propose to Akane, so it's not all bad.
One person needs to die.
What?
Just one more person, and Akane and Carlos can...
Junpei! You!
Wait, Junpei!
Hey!
Hello?
Junpei!
You? What rule? What rule did we break?
Punished?
Time to exterminate.
Exterminate?
Why send Q after us if there's like injectors in our bracelet that can kill us? Why not just hit us with one of those?
Shift.
That's it. Shift.
I could shift. There's no way I'm leaving Junpei Kai behind.
Can't they shift too?
Create another history and jump right back. Where do I go? Which history should I jump to? Damn it! I don't have time to think. Then.
No!
I'm sorry. I couldn't avenge you.
Akane? I just killed...
And now we're sending this broken and battered fucking Carlos to...
No. Why is it Connie? This is the history where Connie was killed. I killed her. No. I didn't kill her. The one who did was me from this history.
That's still you.
This can't be kept like this. I need to do something at least.
Why are you taking that with you?
The anesthetic worked somehow. The pain still. I don't know how long it'll last.
Oh, the anesthetic from the thing on your arm.
I have to figure out who he is somehow. Yeah, there's one more thing I need to do. That vision I saw, I have to tell QT. Counting on you, Gab. He might have been the one who killed Junpei in this history.
Okay. So now we go to Q Team. Right here. Oh, right, now I have to put up with this idiot.
I think... I knew it!
What is it?
It's a note.
A note?
Search the family portrait.
Hey, where are you going? Damn it.
Put the fucking gun down.
There's something special about this?
The note said to examine the family portrait.
Who is it from?
The air vent connects to Ward C, so I guess.
Carlos.
This picture must have something.
Wait, maybe this is a trap? He did kill Junpei and Akane. He could be planning to... I told you to hold on a minute!
Let go! Let go of me!
Whoa!
A door. It's a door.
What's a door doing here?
No, Wynn's birthday.
Twin's birthday?
Huh?
Look, it's written right here.
Twin's birthday, huh? Okay, I'm lost. What's the big deal?
It's gotta be some kind of hint, I think.
For what?
Opening this door.
But it's totally blank. There's no input screen or confirmation device.
Yeah, no keyholes or buttons or switches either. Checking Mira's body.
Why?
Well, maybe she was holding on to a remote or something like that.
Wait! Let me do it.
Nothing?
No. She didn't have anything.
Huh?
There's something on her nails. What's that doing there?
Well, it doesn't look like she has any external wounds. So that means...
This isn't Mira's blood and skin?
Well, she must have struggled with someone, won't she?
Killer should have scratches from Mira. Somewhere on their body.
Should I take my clothes off?
No.
But it's pretty strange.
What is?
Well, I thought up until now that Mira had been killed while she was asleep, after she'd been injected with the X-Men. But if she put on...
She couldn't have been asleep. Twin's birthday.
Sigma. It's after 0230. I guess we're not gonna be injected with the drugs.
The game is over. There's no more reason to make us sleep.
Akane will come back. Right?
If she doesn't...
I'm turning on the transporter.
It's pointless. We've tried a bunch of times already. We did everything we could, but it's still as dead as a doorknob.
Once a transportation gets back, it takes roughly 10 months to recover.
So, what should we do for now?
I checked out the counter at the bar. It seems like we're good on food for a while.
How long will it last?
With frugal eating, we'll have enough for 10 months.
So we have enough time to use the transporter again.
I did say frugally, didn't I? My calculations are based on half a can a day.
You remembered to include Gab, right?
Of course. There's no way I could abandon him.
In a pinch, you could always eat him.
Let's rest for
now. That was a joke.
We'll figure
that was a joke.
What is it?
Does something seem different about this now?
What?
I thought there were walls inside here.
Maybe it was your imagination.
They deactivated the bomb?
Eat.
I'm not hungry.
Just do it. When I come here.
Do you know what this is?
Hey, that's Fi's brooch. Why do you have it?
I don't know. It was in my pocket for some reason.
Not in this timeline.
I truly wish that's true.
Was that the TV turning on? Are you gonna take a shower or are you just gonna sit there, Diana? Don't see, don't know. It's not peaceful for those the people suffering that, though.
You don't have to worry about seeing how happy your friends are on social media. Like,
what?
I have a new boyfriend, or my child just turned one. Look at all this amazing food I ate at this gorgeous restaurant. I got tired of seeing it.
Diana hates Twitter. the fucking music box.
Do you know Maeterlinx, the blue bird? This is a music box using it as a motif. What is it?
Oh, nothing. So, what about it is the same?
You know how, in the end, the bird was in Tyltyl and Mytyl's home all along?
But it flies away.
All across the world in search of it. This feels similar. I guess. I mean to say, happiness is closer than you think.
In this shelter?
Yes.
I'm sorry, Diana. Your interpretation is wrong. In the original book, the bluebird escapes the cage, flies away. Happiness slipped through your fingers. Only you believe you have it. It's implying that the process of dreaming is true happiness.
You just ruined my dream, then.
Touché. Sorry.
You won't disappear. Will you? Sigma?
One day we all disappear.
She still had the bracelet on when she left here. And if so, then there's a chance that Zero injected her again, so she...
No, that's not it. Akane... Akane betrayed us. She murdered Carlos and Junpei and abandoned us just to escape on her own. Maybe Carlos voted for Q-Team because she manipulated him into doing it.
Diana... What's gotten into you all of a sudden? A half a month ago, you were happy, saying it was peaceful.
That was then. This is now.
Has something changed?
No! Nothing's changed. Not a single thing. That's why I'm annoyed.
Four.
Yesterday, today, it's all the same. Same scenery, the same can. I feel like I'm losing my mind.
I think you might be.
Ugh, it's all Rebecca's fault.
What?
She was the head nurse. Ugh, she was the one to suggest I join this experiment.
I'm not so sure you should be blaming her. You had another reason for signing up for the experiment, didn't you? You're single now, Diana. You were married before, weren't you?
Yes. But why do you know that?
When you were married, your husband often resorted to beating you. He was an alcoholic and recently unemployed. He screwed up at work, garnering a large debt, if I recall correctly. When the two of you dated, he came across as serious and kind. But no longer. Right to his eyeballs, he was always gambling. Would laugh while he kicked and punched you. For no reason. That was his true face. Of course you left him. But even after the divorce, he persisted in following you around. He'd ask you for money and sex. And if you said no, he beat you black and blue.
Then get a restraining order.
He was even stopped by the hospital cafeteria. We were having lunch with a co-worker of yours. He showed up out of the blue, screaming his head off, and flipped the table. Every time he went off on you, he'd always end with, "I love you. I love you so much, Diana." Weep. His pain called out to you, and you'd always find yourself caving in. In order to cut all contact with him, you figured the only way it'd work would be to seclude yourself. That's when Rebecca brought it up. I heard about a job at an experiment facility called DECOM. So you...
Stop! Stop it! What is the meaning of this? Why do you know?
Would you believe me if I said I heard it from you?
Stop playing around.
Dog. Dog.
You should probably stop now.
Can't you leave me alone? What are you doing?
You're not acting like yourself.
You're the super weird one here. Ugh. It's been a whole month and a half. How can you be so calm about all this?
I have some experience with this kind of thing.
Stop talking your nonsense. Give it back.
No.
I said give it back! Hey! Look what you did!
Hey, stop!
What are you doing? Oh, she's gone crazy!
You're so silly. You thought I was serious? Like, I'd actually like that?
Diana, you're...
I can't take it anymore! I'm so sick of this!
Dog!
Hey, sleep with me?
What?
Do you... hate me?
Of course not.
Then sleep with me. Come on, hurry!
She's gone insane. She's more than drunk. She's literally insane.
The bombs, coward. Then, how about... Won't you kill me? Please. Kill me.
What are you saying?
I'd rather be killed by someone now than wait to die, wasting away in this.
Just cut it out. Wait, where are you going?
No, it isn't!
Forgive me.
How is it your fault? How is it Sigma's fault?
I could see how you felt. I knew you were crying out for help. But not once did I offer a hand. I couldn't. If we got too close, then I felt like something shattered.
What?
You said you should.
happiness could be found here. I knew you were putting on a brave face. In reality, the one who believed what you said was me. It's just like you said. I'm not brave. I'm a coward and a wimp. Deep down inside, I was scared of change.
What? What? Isn't Sigma's mind that of a... What if we had sex in the teleportation pod? Isn't Sigma's mind that of an old fucking man? And Diana's like 20-something? This is no-no territory.
Go to the moon, right? You've been obsessed with it since you were a kid. Even your name, Diana, is from the goddess of the moon.
Hey, Sigma, can you tell me now why you know so much about me?
Well, I've lived with you. 3 years. So I know almost everything about you.
Huh?
Wait, so Diana was the woman.
It's not your fault you don't understand. I'm talking about the future. But this history doesn't mean it's an extension of that. It's a different one. Okay, so hypothetically, let's say right now we're on this new level. If you continue on the path, you'll only reach the end of the right times. You'll never go to the left ones. I was just talking about the left leg path. Sorry. I started talking nonsense again.
Yes, believe I'm me. An old man.
Yeah, I do. I think it rather makes the dream better.
What? Because he's an old man?
I need to tell you something. Sigma, I may be...
Don't.
Did amazing, Diana. It's a healthy boy.
Wait, hold on. Something. I think there's another.
Cute. So cute.
Yes.
Who'd have thought you'd have fraternal
twins?
What if
we gave birth in the shower?
Didn't realize?
I did have a hunch. But I couldn't be be sure.
It doesn't matter. I'm just glad you gave birth safely. Even in a place like this.
It's all because of you, Sigma.
Sigma.
Thank you.
Stop.
She sucked her ball! She sucked her ball! His balls! Sigma balls! That's what he said to her!
Truly, I couldn't be more proud. You know how people claim...
Sigma says to Diana, Sigma balls, and then...
I thought it was a lie. I thought there's no way something like that exists. I'm a selfish bastard. Every time I hope so, in the back of my mind, I'm expecting recompense. Whether it be gratitude, praise, or for a higher power to approve of me. Now, I know. There really is such a thing as unconditional love in this world. There's no doubt in my mind that I give my life for them. Not for gratitude or praise. I don't believe in God. It's not for God. I need nothing in return. I don't care if I fade away. I just want them to be safe. And to survive. That's all I ask.
But now you can only be alive for even less time because you have two kids. Oh wait, no, breast milk. That's right.
Listen. You know that biscuit I just gave you? That was the last one. There's nothing else left. Thanks for everything. You've gone through so much pain. You always listened to me when I vented to you.
You vented? You're the imposter? Sigma vented?
Diana, I want to show you.
Sigma balls?
Follow me.
The transporter's turned on.
I came by earlier and noticed it. It appears to be completely charged.
Sigma.
That's right. I'm transporting these two.
What?
Don't worry. Transporting them doesn't mean they'll disappear.
They'll just make a copy for them.
Their original bodies stay behind after they're scanned.
Then...
Are you going to say it's pointless? We're out of food. If we simply do nothing... You understand? Sure you would. But it'll take another 10 months to recharge.
So you're saying this would be the last time we can use it, then?
Which means we can't stay with them.
I know.
Each pod must be
too dangerous.
Then, the past?
There's no point to send them to the near future. Sometime before Zero obtains this device, they'll have to go before the year 2009. Did you think of a name?
What about you? I'd name him if it was was a boy. You would if I was a girl.
Then we'll start with the boy.
Sigma, your name is from the Greek letter Sigma, right? So,
no, it's named after Sigma Balls.
Name our son, Delta. My first initial is D. And then to connect that D to a Greek letter...
Delta? I like it.
What about the girl?
Oddly enough, I was considering a Greek letter too. I want to use the one that means the most.
Is it?
Fine. I'd like to name our daughter after her.
Fine. I think it's perfect.
So, I know where this goes. Spoilers, by the way. But, even if I didn't, I think I'd catch on by this point that...
We gave them their names. It wouldn't be right if someone changed them, would it?
So what, you're writing on their... fucking Woody style? Fucking Andy on the feet?
That's...
Fi's brooch.
You're sending it with her?
Yes.
It was a memento from her mother. So anyway, I would have been able to guess where this is going. So, think about this for a second, and then remember back to Virtue's... So keeping in mind that Fi is Sigma's daughter, if you go back to Virtue's Last Reward, where Sigma is fucking hitting on Fi and talking about seeing her in a swimsuit, yeah, he's, one, he's in an old man's body, and two, he's her father. So that makes that scene even more fucked up. Because now, not only is an old man hitting on Fi, but an old man who's also Fi's father is hitting on Fi. Albeit, he doesn't know that yet because it's his young mind, but the body is that of his father. Is that the end? What was their birthday? 11-9-2029? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 11-16. That's going to be a next time on the stream. Thank you all very much for watching the stream. Let's get some fucking music. Thank you all very much for watching the stream. Is anyone live right now? Let's check Twitch. Nothing. Alright, thank you all very much for watching the stream. Remember to follow. I'll see you later. Bye-bye.